Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel. I'm super excited for today's video. It is 11 things or habits that make women more attractive. Now, women are already beautiful and attractive as is, but these are different habits that you can add into your daily life or into your mind that I feel can help every woman be more attractive. So if you're interested in this video, please keep watching. So my first tip on the different habits that you can do and add to your life that can help make you more attractive is to plan your outfits the night before. So we all know the struggles of being a woman, getting ready in the morning, and not knowing what to wear. It can be the most frustrating thing. I think it's worse when you end up just settling with something that you wear that you're not in love with, because I feel like whatever you put on your body, if you don't feel confident or good in it, it kind of sets the tone of your whole day. So if you just prepare and plan out your outfits the night before, you can even post pictures in your closet. Take a day to plan for outfit making and lay them out and take pictures of it laid out, or take pictures of you in the outfit. Print them out and post them in your closet. That way every time you go in your closet, if you're pressed for time, you can just look at some of those put together outfits that you already have planned out and choose one of them and just throw it on. That way you know these are outfits that you actually like and love. I definitely think that when I feel like I like what I'm wearing, it helps me feel better about myself. So planning your outfit helps you look more put together. In turn, it helps you feel good, feel comfortable, and if you feel like you look good, I feel like you're gonna have a great day. All right, with that, my second tip is to have your staple shoe that goes with everything. Another issue with getting ready, you can have the perfect outfit, but again, another issue can be, what shoe do I wear? I get that question a lot, what shoe goes with certain outfits? Some people have a really hard time figuring that out. And so for me, I made a video talking about 10 shoes every woman needs, and I will link that up here or in the description box below. Basically, nude and black shoes are colors that basically will go with everything. If you had to choose one color, I'd go with the color nude. I feel like a one strap heel as well as a pointy toe pump in nude is something that will go with everything. It's simple, it's not too crazy, it's also classic, so again, other reasons why it will go with every outfit. Having these types of shoes definitely saves you a lot of time, takes the guesswork out of it all. Alright, tip number three is taking care of your skin. So the more that you take care of your skin, the less you have to do. The less makeup you'll feel like you'll need to wear. So definitely learn what skin type you have, talk to someone, talk to an esthetician or a dermatologist to figure out what type of skincare you should be buying and you should be using. All right, my next tip or a habit that you can do to make yourself more attractive is to have eye contact and to pay attention. In this day and age, again, social media and just being on your phones in general is such a big part of everyone's lives. I feel like we're all losing that eye contact, that personable conversation that we used to have. So I think as a woman, if you pay attention to the other person, or if you're just attentive and you're there and you're present in the moment and you have good eye contact, it really says a lot about you. I think it stands out nowadays, and it's just a beautiful thing. All right, my next tip is to be confident. Now, confidence is something that is pretty obvious that will help make you more attractive, but it's something that also comes from within, so it's not really something that I can tell you how to get. For me, confidence is being put together, putting an effort into just my everyday life, from my hair to my makeup to my clothes. That on the outside helps me feel good on the inside, and if I don't feel good on the inside, it's definitely just being aware of that and working on that to get better every day. So whatever being confident means to you, or if you're not there yet, at least putting the time and the effort in to getting there is definitely something and a habit that will make you more attractive. All right, my next tip is to have good posture. Good posture is something that can help you in the long run, and bad posture is something that can definitely be detrimental to you later on in the long run. And so it's a no-brainer to try to practice good posture at all times. I know I have to constantly remind myself to sit up straight, you know, have my neck be aligned, especially because I'm always on the computer. But having good posture is definitely a great habit to have. All right, my next tip is try not to cuss. Leave the bad words out. I know as women, there are days when we just feel like we have to. I do it a lot. Jamie hates it when I do it, and I hate it when I do it as well. But there's something just so classic about a woman that speaks eloquently. But I think leaving the bad words out of our vocabulary is a really good habit to do and remind ourselves every day. All right, my next tip is be positive. I feel like we are our harshest critic. It's super easy to break ourselves down. I myself am very guilty of just kind of worrying sometimes, and it doesn't ever help me. So I always need to try to have a positive mindset, tell myself daily affirmations, and those things really make a difference in my everyday life. Now, being positive is something easier said than done. I feel like you need to find what being positive means to you and how you can do different things on a daily basis to help you be more positive. That makes all the difference. Just saying to be positive is not really gonna help much unless you actually put action into it. Nobody wants to hang around with a negative Nancy all the time. You can definitely spot and feel those people from a mile away just in the way they speak, the way they speak about other people. So if you are noticing that you are around people that are like that as well, that are negative, it can be really easy to fall into that same trap and get out while you can. All right, my next tip, and one of the biggest ones I want to stress, is to be happy and be supportive of other women. Now, being in this industry, I'm surrounded by a bunch of women, and just being on YouTube in general, I feel like we should all be on the same team. I know it can kind of be hard. I feel like women are just each other's biggest competition sometimes, and it shouldn't be that way. We can all learn from each other. There is so much that I've learned from being in this industry and talking to other women in the field that I'm in. So I feel like if you guys are ever feeling like negative towards another woman, you don't even know why, I think taking a step back and being aware of that and asking yourself why you feel this way and taking the necessary steps to kind of get your mind right so that you don't make that a habit is super important. Everyone's on their own journey. Whatever battle you're fighting, everyone else out there is fighting their own battle. And so if you can make it a habit to change the way you think, then you're on the right path to being a happier, more supportive, more attractive woman. All right, my next tip is to work out. Working out increases serotonin, releases a bunch of endorphins. All of this helps make you feel better, makes you more positive and more happy overall. So not even working out just to look good, working out just to feel good. I think that's a super important habit. I always find that after a good workout, if I'm having a bad day, it always helps turn things around. I just feel so much better. I'm doing something productive with myself and my body. It's always positive to work out. It's always something good. These things help make you happy and feel good, and so that definitely exudes attraction. Also, try not to make excuses for not working out. You can be super busy, but there are a bunch of workouts at home that you can do straight from YouTube. Just type in what you're looking for and hit the play button, and you can have a quick and easy 30-minute workout. All right, my next habit is to just make an effort in general. I know a lot of you guys are moms out there. Maybe you don't have much time to do anything for yourself, but again, as I always remind you guys are worth it. You guys deserve so much because you sacrifice so much. And even if you're not a mom, but you're always out of time, just making little concerted efforts here and there can make a big difference rather than just not making an effort at all. Just in anything in life in general, knowing that you made an effort in whatever it is you're doing, whether it's getting ready or in your job. I think mentally it can make you feel better knowing that you tried. People will see that. They will think that it is an attractive trait that you have. And I think you'll feel much better about yourself. All right, you guys, that is it for this video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. I hope you found it useful. If you did, give me a thumbs up. Leave me a comment down below if you like this video and if you want me to do more like this one. Again, if you made it this far but you have not already, please subscribe to my channel by hitting that red subscribe button down below. Hit the notification bell as well. That way you don't miss out on any new videos. If you want daily outfit inspirations, follow me on Instagram. I'm just Naomi Boyer. And I'll see you guys in my next video. Thank you.